Hi, this is Paul Solt from iPhone Dev TV. I want to give you a series of videos on how to make your very first iPhone game. And the first thing that we're going to focus on is the user interface and how we can overlay different buttons and options on top of our game windows. And so this is what we're doing in Bomb Dodge, and I just fixed a bug with it. And I wanted to show you how we do it in our game so that you can get started. And this is going to be a way for you to organize multiple screens on your iPhone game, and you can connect the buttons. So we're going to build this up. There's going to be a bunch of videos. There's going to be a bunch of code, and we're just going to jump right into it. So let me show you what we're building. Right here, we have two buttons. Now, you can imagine having your game start screen like Angry Birds here, and you'd have some kind of image that an artist would make. Now, after that, you'll hit the play button to start the game. You might go directly into the game, or you might have some options to do something else. Right now, this is a really simple game. I just have a game loop that is causing some animation to happen so I can actually interact with this. And I get points for moving these views around. Now, one of the things that does happen is I lose points when I'm not moving these things around. So it's a super simple game. It's nothing complex. We've got points along the top, and then I'm moving things around. And then I can hit the pause screen. Here we're playing with some UI dynamics. We're using physics to draw some of this stuff. We're gonna look into that a little bit. And you can then interact with these buttons to unpause the game. And so these are just some different things that you can do with the iPhone capabilities. We also have a store screen here. And so we can transition to here where we can make purchases. And this could be hooked up to in-app purchases so that when you tap one of these numbers, you see that you are getting something here. So that's our store screen. And our store screen is accessible from two different places. So if I go to the main menu, you'll see that we also have a store button here. And this will show us the same thing. It loads the same data, and we're able to interact with it in the same way. So it's just different ways to get to the same content from different hierarchies in your application. So this is actually a custom view controller that's using the UI view controller containment APIs so that we can present everything and so that we can actually overlay UI on top of our game window. So we've got two view controllers here, and I'll show you how to do everything like we do in our game. All right, so let's get started. I am going to open up Xcode and start a brand new project. And this will be a single view application. We'll call this Game Menus 101. And we're going to make this just for iPhone. I'll hit Next. I'll put this in my Projects folder. And we're ready to get started. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to be using auto layout in this for everything. We're going to need two buttons on our main screen. So let's just drag out those buttons. We're going to have a play button, and then we're going to have a store button. Now, what I want to do with these buttons is I do want to use a background image. So if we pull the project down, I have these three assets that I can just drag into the project, and I'll just copy them in. And then I want to put these in the assets catalog. So I'm just going to click on assets. And then down here along the plus, I can import from the project. And I'll import all four files. We can enable this to just make sure that nothing bad happens. And then the thing that I care about right now is this one button. So we're going to select that. And then we're going to do show slicing. And I'll start slicing on this image. We'll just click this. We'll go with the default slicing. Now, it's a little hard to see since everything is white here. So let me give you the preview right here. You can see we've got this little white button thing, and I want it to be stretchable in both the horizontal and vertical directions. So slicing is a quick way to get that to work. Now I'm going to jump back to my main storyboard, and in here we are going to set the background image. So I'm going to select both files holding the Shift key, and then we set the background using the one button. Now, it looks a little bit funky here, but when we actually run the app, it will look a lot better. And what I want to do is probably drag these out to be a certain size. I think we'll go, let's go 140 for both of these buttons. So I'm just going to make them 140 pixels big and that should match. Now, they're a little hard to see with the background, so let's change the background color so that they're more obvious. We have a background color. We're on this sidebar tab if you don't have it open, and then we're on this little tab right here. Now, we're going to look for the view options, and then white color is here. Let's go with a light gray color so that these stand out. So those are our two buttons, but I'm making a game that I want in landscape view. So we're going to switch our view controller. And the way to do that is to select the view controller from here, or just to scroll down and select it by selecting this bar. When we do that, we're going to change the orientation to landscape. And so this is going to give us that landscape view, which is going to be important for the stuff that we're doing with this game. And now we're going to want to rearrange our buttons. So let's hide this panel on the right for a moment. And I want to space out the buttons so that they're a certain distance apart, and then we'll center them. So with them centered, we can go ahead and right now it's trying to run on my iPhone, but I want to show you guys, so we'll run on the simulator. So let's hit this start button. And if we give it a second. All right, so we've got our buttons. We see that they are resizing. They look a little bit weird. So let's go in there and make them a little bit taller. So I'm going to make them maybe 40 pixels tall. And just make sure that the spacing is right. I'll select both of them, adjust them so that they're centered, and we can stop and rerun. All right, so that's looking more like the button that I was looking for. I'm just going to move Xcode over. All right, so the next thing we want to do here is you'll notice that the image looks weird here, but when we actually run the app, it works fine. The problem is we're not getting the portrait app. So we've designed the user interface for the landscape view, but there's actually a project setting under the game menu. So open your left tab, which is this button right here, so that'll show or hide it, and then select the project, and then we'll go to targets. And under targets, we want to make sure that we turn off portrait. And we'll just go landscape left and landscape right. And that should make our app so that it plays in this orientation. Now, if you're good with proportions, you'll notice that our center line is right here and our buttons are offset. That's because we're running on the iPhone 4, which has a 3.5-inch screen. And so we'll use auto layout to fix this issue. And so this is really easy to get started with. It's confusing if you don't have someone to walk you through it, so I'll just walk you through how we're going to do this. I want this play button to be centered, so I am going to right-click and drag up into the gray area. So if you just right-click and drag up, or you can use a two-finger click and drag and then let go, we can center this horizontally in the container. With auto layout, we are describing the placement of our buttons. So we always want these buttons to be centered along this horizontal axis. So if we're on a smaller screen, it should be centered. If we're on an iPad, it should be centered. The actual pixel coordinate isn't important here. It's the fact that we're giving it a rule using auto layout. And so with this rule, we can set this play button. Now we'll see that there's this really small thing here. In order to fix that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click and drag and then select width. I want the width to be constant, and then I want it to be also centered in the vertically. So if I click on this, this will now go blue on me. And so that's a good thing, whereas this one doesn't have any lines yet. So if we go ahead, stop and run, we now see that the play button is centered in the middle and its size changed. And so we don't want the size to change. So we're actually going to select it again and make sure that we set the height. So I'm right clicking and I'm dragging down to set the height. So now I have a bunch of constraints set up that's going to describe how big this is. I need to do the same thing for this one. And we're going to make this relative placement. So the store button is going to be right under the play button. So if I just drag up, we can set a vertical space. And then you'll see that we have the same issue with the width. So we'll set the width by dragging left, and then we'll drag down to set the height. With that, there's one more thing that we need to do. We haven't described where it is in relation to the center. So what I can do here is just align it to the center of the play button. And now all of the lines should be blue. If that's the case for you, you can continue working. Otherwise, go back and try and fix it. And so we'll see now I have the button centered, and they behave like an iOS 7 app where they sort of fade out in opacity. So that's getting our buttons set up. The next thing I'm going to do is create some methods that we can connect to. So if we open our viewcontroller.m, I'm going to delete the did receive memory warning since we don't need that. And this extra comment we don't need either. So what we're going to do here is add two methods. And I'm going to show you how to do this in code first. And then when we do the other screens, I'll show you how to do it with Interface Builder's assistant editor. So right here, I'm going to do dash and then IB action in parentheses. And then this will be the play button pressed. So IB action is allowing the Interface Builder to see that, oh, I have an action that I can connect to code. And so what we're doing here is we are going to be connecting our user interface to code. So if I just write these two methods, these will give me two access points, and we'll see these dots appear. So now in the main storyboard, what I can do, actually before we do that, let's just print out a message saying that play was pressed, and let's print out a message saying that store was pressed. Now we're not going to implement all the logic yet. It's going to take multiple videos to get to that point. But we're stubbing out the basic functionality for how this app will work. So this is our first screen, and we'll build it up screen by screen. Now, to connect to the code, what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag over to the view controller. You can either drag here, and you'll see that we have two events that we can tie this to. So I want the play button for play, and then instead of dragging here, I'm going to drag over to the left to the document view, and I'll do store button is pressed. Now, if we go ahead, stop, and run this, you should see that everything is working, and we see messages when we press those buttons. So I can keep pressing store, and you'll see that the timestamp changes, and the same with play. So that is our first screen, and this is where all the magic's going to happen. In the next video, I'm going to work on setting up this view controller so that it can manage all of the different screens for our game, and we're going to add two methods that will show different view controllers and then hide the view controllers. And this will give us the capability of displaying our user interfaces from different view controllers on top of our actual game window. So we can have special UI that we develop with Interface Builder on top of the actual game.